Hello, Seattle.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Wholly independent and completely untethered since 2009, this is the Marty Reimer Show podcast.
Reimer, Reimer.
From their West Side basement.
West Side.
Lodged between the mold and the bad memories.
Marty's story is like many of the others. It started with marijuana cigarettes.
Here are your hosts, Jody Brothers and Marty Reimer.
Marty Reimer.
You got away from me, didn't you?
All right, welcome to Friday. Well, hold on. I don't have any paper to shuffle because I forgot to pull the paper off the printer
back there. Give him shuffle paper.
I have to have, otherwise I don't look like a network news anchor.
Right. And with your fancy new haircut.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, there you go.
Welcome to the podcast. It is Friday. That is when we're laying this down. It is the first day of Rocktober.
Yep.
It also, it used to drive people crazy at the radio job at the Mountain when I used to, because it sounded too auburn to call it Rocktober.
And stupid also.
Oh, that too. In general, those that's what our air check meetings were like after every show.
You guys are stupid.
You sounded stupid today. Can you sound less stupid? No.
We'll give it a shot, boss, but we can't promise anything.
Screw you. Why don't you go back to Yakima? That is exactly what our meeting sounded like. Today marks the six-month anniversary. You'd be surprised we made it this far, considering what you've heard so far on the podcast today. Six-month anniversary of our podcast.
Yay! Remember the deal that you and I made in the beginning?
We struck a deal at the very beginning that we wouldn't talk about making money until 6 months in.
So,
And now, doom.
What are we going to do about not making any money?
Let's put that off. We have a very special guest joining us today, comedian Jake Johansson.
Yay!
And this is what makes the podcast so cool and unique is that Jake is not actually here, but he's coming sometime mid-show.
Yeah.
We just are going to, he's going to come up the driveway.
Yeah.
Past the playset.
Uh-huh.
Into the glass doors.
Uh-huh.
And he will be seated. It'll all happen live.
Yes.
So we will interrupt whatever we're doing and bring Jake Johansson into the fold when he arrives.
And we'll be okay with this method of doing it because Laughs has a lot of really good comics coming up, like through the fall and into 2011, a lot of people that we're going to want to talk to. And they like to put them on Q13 Fox News at 9:15, and we can't compete with that.
Someone on Facebook just said they saw Jake Johansson on Q13, said he was hilarious there, so they're looking forward to hearing him, seeing him here on the Whipcast.
Absolutely, he is hilarious.
All right. So that is coming up in just a little bit. I wonder if by chance you heard the news, really, in our industry, about as stunning a news item as happens from time to time.
Yeah.
Has ever happened.
No.
Another one has bitten the dust.
Yeah.
Yesterday, being the last month of September. Walks fairly down the street
with the brim pool way down low. I gotcha.
Yesterday being the last month of September, and apparently the last month of a massive radio contract here in the city of Seattle, it was the last day of the Bob Rivers show on KZOK.
Such a huge mistake for KZOK.
And we have been looking at this, you know, since we got let go a year ago, we have been kind of looking at the radio landscape in Seattle. And I mean, it's no secret that my feelings about it, that radio is dead.
Yeah.
And that in 5 years, gone.
Yeah.
And I'm now, and at first I was saying it kind of tongue in cheek. And now I'm starting to feel like, wow, I'm really a seer.
Yeah.
A seer of the future. Because, I could always explain away our firing by personality conflict.
Sure.
Everyone hated Jody. It was my mistake to bring her into the show. And so
when I brought you down.
When they fired Jody, I said, but me too. And they said, you're a package deal. You're going too, jackass.
I don't want to interrupt your flow here, Mega Man, but it was actually the reverse.
Oh, the other way around?
I was extremely well liked.
Shocking to me. Think that
I know. Well, your contract was up.
My contract was up and yours wasn't.
Yeah, so they could.
But I always felt it was somewhat personal because there was one guy there that I just couldn't. He was destroying what was so near and dear to me because that radio station was really a part of me.
Yeah,
it's a rare situation in radio where you actually get to work at a radio station that you would listen to,
right?
And that you were proud, like at gatherings, to say that's where I work, and I'm thrilled about it. And then there was one guy who ruined it. Over the course of 2 years, he destroyed it.
Right.
And the entire time it was being withered away, I kept saying, wake up, people. Right. Why isn't anyone else realizing this? And I destroyed my
reputation. Right.
Because I all of a sudden I became hard to work with.
Yes.
Which, as we all know, yes.
I can't believe they would say that about you.
And so when the new guy came in, he just thought, well, I'm gonna make things happen.
And he was told that you were hard to work with, and apparently he was told that I was hard to work with too, because he hated me from the beginning. And I'm extremely pleasant.
He hated you more than he hated me.
He really did. Yeah, he thought I was passive aggressive, and I was like, I'm hourly aggressive.
Yes.
Passive aggressive. You're not even trying to get to know me.
I had one-on-ones with him going, "You don't understand, Jody. Aggressive aggressive is the way to describe it.
I mean, at least give me a minute. Passive aggressive, never.
So I always explained our firing away as being, okay, that could be somewhat personal. Now that Bob Rivers has been let go, and in the interim, Ichabod Crane, who is a legendary radio personality on country radio, was let go.
Yeah.
Basically, is there anything left? I mean, now the morning radio especially is just a vacuum. It's so sad.
And there's a couple choices. You know, you still got BJ on the air. You have Jackie and Bender. You have Fitz. There's a couple things here and there, but there's no choices. You know, there used to be a lot of us. It was crowded. We had a lot of competition. You know, now it's like five. You could count them on your hand how many shows there are to listen to. I feel bad for people who enjoy listening to morning radio. You know, conversational morning radio where you get your news and also some entertainment, maybe like one or two songs. It's just not available.
People would stick ping pong balls in listeners' butts.
Those are
like
the days. Eggs.
Was it eggs?
I never stuck a ping pong ball in anybody's
mouth. Oh, yeah. You were far too sophisticated for that.
Hard-boiled eggs. For incubus tickets. Those were the days.
We've been strategizing as if we had any kind of influence in the industry whatsoever. Yeah. We've been strategizing over the last 6 months because we knew that Bob Rivers' contract was up.
And everybody has been talking about what's going to happen.
And for those that aren't on the inside, Bob Rivers was by far, by a factor of, let me just say safely, by a factor of 8, maybe even 10, the highest paid radio show in Seattle.
And deservedly so, you know, top of the pile for 10 years at the same place, and you get raises, and there's a lot of people on that show, and they all work really hard from an insider's perspective. I've been on the inside. I'm the insider's perspective. I'm talking about myself.
I'm not questioning what you're saying.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I was questioning whether or not I should reveal numbers here.
I don't think so. Because we don't have accurate numbers. You have speculation numbers.
Speculation numbers.
Yeah.
Multiple millions of dollars.
Right. Because it's...
Many millions of dollars.
Because it's like 9 people on his staff.
And a radio show typically, a morning radio show typically, even a well-paid one.
Yeah.
Doesn't make over $400,000 a year.
No.
So that's what the industry was faced with. Yeah. And Bob was kind of, I mean, to his credit, he was kind of the last bastion of that old school, big mammoth morning radio show.
Right.
And it wasn't just the Seattle industry that was looking at him. It was the whole country because he was, I think, the highest paid west of the Mississippi or something. And so everyone was seeing, okay, are they going to renew his contract? And you and I would have these arguments that I'd say, well, of course they'd like to keep him.
Right.
But not at this price.
Right.
I mean, this is that now, every time they renegotiate a contract now, they always say, you know, this is the post-recession economy.
You should be lucky to have jobs.
Yeah. We have friends who are like telling us about their contract negotiations and they say, I'd like a 4% cost of living raise. And they'll say, you'll take a 10% cut and be happy with it.
Literally.
Seriously. That's exactly what's going on in contract negotiations around town with people that are getting paid a minuscule fraction of what Bob Rivers and his clan were making.
And it's so funny because like watching them was sort of like going to be definitive of what happened with radio in general. And you were saying it's, you know, they're not going to renew. It's not going to work out. And I was saying, yes, they will.
Yeah,
they
right.
could never let him go.
That was
it's
the argument between
happen.
Us all the time.
Yeah.
You know, Jody was going, there's no way they can afford to let him go. And I'm like going, nothing personal about Bob. I think he's very talented. And the whole crew worked very hard. But this has nothing to do with any individual. And right. now I truly believe it. Because I thought I got fired for personal reasons, and now I go, oh, it's all just about finances.
Nah, you got fired for personal reasons.
Well,
we weren't making that much, Marty. I mean, you made like probably triple what I made. I made nothing.
In relation to the rest of the station.
Yeah.
And I'm just telling you, anything is too much.
I know.
Look, they look at Jack FM and they say, here's an iPod plugged into a transmitter. And it's getting, with this new rating system that was implemented about a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, it's getting good ratings.
Yeah.
And so they say, look, if we're paying anyone, then we're doing something wrong.
I know. And Rivers has to be in the same building with Jack FM.
Seriously, he had a computer down the hall that was getting paid nothing. He was getting paid $3-4 million a year. And
I know. And it's such crap, too, because doing like creative talk radio and you get out and do events and appearances and you try and make it interesting and just nobody gives a crap anymore.
It all started with Clinton. I mean, we're fans of Clinton, but his communication deregulation in the 90s destroyed the industry. That's when it all started crumbling. Because think about it. Back in the old days, a company could only own one FM and one AM in a market.
Yeah.
That was it. And then they loosened all those rules because radio stations weren't making enough money.
Right.
How can the big corporations roll in and really kill it? So then they said, all right, I think you can own 7 FM radio stations and countless AM stations. At that point, they were just throwing those away. So is Jake Johansson out weed whacking? Because I hear a weed whacker going and Yaz just went out, running out.
Yeah, he's going out to check so that you can continue with your flow.
Well, apparently
no, that didn't happen. Who's using a weed whacker?
He is here.
He is here?
Yep.
With a weed whacker?
I don't think that was him. I think it's one of your neighbors. Weed whacking.
Does Yaz know what Jake Johansson looks like? Maybe there's just a gardener across the street. And, yes, Jake is here.
Well, we know what he looks like.
All right. Anyhow, we wish Bob well. It's still interesting to see how this plays out. He's got a 6-month no compete.
Yeah.
And so he's going to lay low for 6 months. We put out the invitation to have him come on the podcast.
Yep.
And he said, as long as legally he's allowed to, he will come on board.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
And that will be exciting to get an inside peek as to what's going on. KZOK apparently is going to turn their morning show into a music morning show.
Yeah.
Because it's cheap.
It is cheap.
And so that's as much as we know. But we had the same kind of arguments between us as to what would happen. And I predicted this would happen.
You did.
I actually said two things. One is this would happen, or that he would understand the landscape and take a 90% pay cut. But then you go, 90% seems like awfully.
I'm so sweet and naive. I was just like, they're never going to let, they couldn't possibly.
Which is, oddly enough, the same thing you said about us.
I know.
Every day when
Marty,
I said,
not going to fire you.
Yeah.
They couldn't possibly.
And then look what happened.
I know.
All right. Hey, our very special guest is here. A dear friend of ours. And he's like, who are you?
I know. Come on. Is it my turn yet?
No. No, the guy behind you. He's the dear friend.
Okay. It's Dave again.
Dave is our dear friend. No, he headlined our second Marty Reamer Funny Festival and just brought the house down.
That's right.
He truly is one of our favorite comedians. Jake Johansson is here.
Yay. Thanks for having me, Marty.
Good morning, Jake.
Good morning. I'm going to take some pictures of us on the... I'm doing my own podcast.
Oh, really?
Are you doing a podcast?
Well, why not? Everybody's doing a podcast.
You should. Comedians understand.
Certainly.
Podcasts.
All comedians are doing podcasts. We have extra time we can spend with you because you were also supposed to do a radio. This is what we were talking about right before we introduced you. You were supposed to be part of a radio show in town today, a radio show that
the
had
other
their,
show.
Yes,
we
the
can.
Other.
Can we? I'm not sure about the. Usually, when you're on a radio show, they don't let you mention the other radio show. But we're not. We're on a. It seems like we're on a radio show, but we're on a podcast.
Right.
Podcast.
It's exactly like a radio show, except it's a pod. It's pod. You listen to it on your pod.
On your pod. Yes.
Yeah.
And all there are no rules here.
We can curse.
Really?
Yeah, if you want to, you can.
Sweet.
Yeah, but
I'm going to warm up to it.
Yeah.
I like to curse.
Do you
a
really?
Little bit.
A little bit.
He'll
fit in perfect. It's a little bit of
shame.
The S word or whatever.
Yeah, the S word. Is that how?
We're still uncomfortable with it.
Yeah. Well, I feel like cursing is. Well, if you could just think of a good replacement word. This morning, when I was on the TV.
You were on the TV.
And the guy said that something. That they couldn't find the guy or his phone, And the way he said phone, it almost sounded like he was about to say the F word in the sentence. I can't remember the sentence. So I feel like you could just replace the F word with phone, and you know.
Well, haven't they done that with freaking?
Yeah.
Like when they say
they have, but that's sort of close to the actual word.
In fact, it's so close that I wonder how do you get away with that?
And everyone knows what you're trying. And they can say it on TV too. Yeah, freaking or frickin'.
Yeah, and friggin'. Radio. Plus, I always laugh at when people say the F word on radio. Because now you're actually saying it.
Yeah, but not really.
Well, in your head, you immediately make the translation.
Yeah. Well, you kind of do, but it's hard to...
I mean, if somebody says on radio, you know, oh, and then you said the F word, do you, in your head, go, fondue?
Which F word is he talking about?
But you can't say that's so F worded up. You can't. Well, you know, you can. It's better to say that's phoned up. That's so phoned up.
Phoned up. You could start a new trend.
Yeah.
You could start
it
here.
Just to replace it. And because if we could switch it over with a word that we're allowed to say, it would be so much better. Because that's a great thing about the phoning, the phone word, is when you say.
You mean the act of phoning?
Yeah. No, I'm not talking about phoning. I'm talking about phoning. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Now I'm totally confused. Yeah. I don't know if you mean phoning or phone.
Yeah, it is tricky because maybe we have to make up a word that no one is even that doesn't. It's a nonsense word. Anyway, when you don't say it, when it seems like you need to say it but you don't say it, then it calls attention to itself.
Yes.
That you know,
even
if
more
you were
so.
If this was a real conversation, you would actually say phone instead of.
I'm so dizzy right
yeah,
now.
So much.
But I did want to ask you something about you. You mentioned that you were on Q13 this morning, and one of our Facebook friends said they saw you there and said you were hilarious.
I got to get more active on Facebook. We did talk about Facebook on. I got to get a podcast. I've got to get on Facebook. I'm on Facebook, but I got to be on there more.
Yeah, you got to be active. Otherwise, people forget you're there. But no, here's what's interesting: is sort of in the hierarchy of looseness. Podcast is at the top of the heap. I mean, there are no rules here. You can say whatever you want. Feel free to talk about other radio shows, that kind of thing. Then there's radio, the traditional broadcast terrestrial radio. And then there's television, where everything's locked down. So as a comedian coming on, doing a morning appearance on a television show, it's like, you got 30 seconds, be funny.
Yeah.
Out.
Well, and then sometimes they're not saying be funny. They're just saying, they just want you to kind of just talk to them. Sometimes they get into that journalism thing where it's just like, so what was it like when you started out Iowa?
Nothing funnier.
And then you were on The Tonight Show. What was that like?
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, I think it was, but it's better if we're talking about something that's kind of funny.
Now,
but when you're doing a podcast, which we're doing, this is a pod, it looks just like we're at a radio station, and that's the thing.
Because the headphones. You've done.
Well, and the big machine.
And
I don't
the big
think
machine.
You need a machine that big to do a podcast.
No, we don't.
We stole that from the radio station.
This is all play school equipment.
Yeah. This is buttons and dials. This one is not hooked up to anything.
No. Yeah.
Very astute of you. Yeah. Is that the first thing you do when you walk into a facility? Is is there anything not plugged in?
What can I spill onto? That's what I'm always kind of thinking. What are we most careful about spilling on? But you're doing it as if it was a radio show.
Yes. And it's live because we are live webcast. That's why that camera is just
so people can see us right now.
Oh yeah, look at
this.
This
is the thing. There is
that
already
looked very threatening when you just pointed right at the people like that.
You know, there's TV, right? Yeah. I mean, people can watch.
What?
Well, this is what
what's
gets
this
me.
You speak of?
When it's a radio show, but then you can also watch the radio show. It just seems like, well, why don't we go ahead and get.
Just do a TV show.
Get rid of the headphones and get some lavalier mics and stand over there, and then it'll be a TV show instead of a radio show that people are watching on TV.
Well,
and then you go on TV and they're trying to get you to go to their website. It's like we're already on TV.
Yeah.
It's just like it'd be like if you get to the moon and you're like, oh, wouldn't it be great if we were on Earth?
I miss Earth.
Yeah, that's where we started out.
Jake Johansson is playing at Laugh's comedy spot in Kirkland and all this weekend. So, and I highly encourage you to check him out. You are, you strike me, and this becomes ever so relevant and sadly poignant this week with the passing of Greg Giraldo, who
sadly
was a friend
poignant.
Of ours.
Terrible.
Yeah, but what you strike me as being one of the most well-balanced comedians in the country.
You seem fine.
It does seem that way, doesn't it?
I mean, whenever Giraldo would come into the room.
This is coming from a guy who's doing a pretend radio show in his basement. Okay.
No, I've diagnosed you. You don't have any problems whatsoever.
We are on the air.
Yeah.
Giraldo, we loved the man. We thought he was smart and wicked funny. But when he came into the room, there was like a dark cloud that would trail him into the room.
Oh, you know, could tell he was cranky.
Oh, he had some demons.
And yet four kids? He had four kids?
Is it four or three?
I thought it was three.
Yeah. Okay, well, three. I was giving him a bonus child. Still three kids. I've only got one kid. He's got three kids, so he's doing something right.
Yeah.
I mean, well, that's the saddest part about it. But but let's just public service announcement.
Uh-huh.
Don't take all your prescription drugs.
Yeah, don't take them all at once.
Yeah,
I think
and
that's
if it says don't drink, then don't drink and stay away from the lawnmower. I just don't even go near the lawnmower if I'm
just
even. Yeah, you save your beer for after you drink. After you mow the lawn, right. You don't drink beer while you're mowing the lawn.
Yeah,
absolutely.
That's smart.
That's
got to tell all the people in my neighborhood. Shirts off, beers, whole thing. Like we're in Indiana.
Get off that mower, jackass!
At the beginning, when you started out, you seemed, and I don't know if this was shtick, but you seemed highly anxious performing, just because you had that little bit of the stutter going.
Yeah. Well, I would think I was anxious. I think I was amplifying an actual thing that was going on inside my body and trying to ride it, surf it, you know, instead of just fighting it. Instead of trying to pretend like I'm not nervous, I'm going to act as if I'm more nervous.
Yeah.
And then see if I can incorporate that into the act. And then if I really am nervous, it doesn't matter because I'm already pretending to be nervous.
Right.
Right. So I do less of that now, but still, there's still a little bit of stammery.
Is that a sign of nervousness or just because you've done it so long?
It's style. It's a style choice
style.
Now.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what
now
we're going
totally,
with, right? Yeah, it's style.
You're
I'm super cool. I could, I could do it without doing that, but I don't because that's not how I do it.
Do you still like the? Now I'm starting to treat you like a straight interview. I've transitioned into just
now. We've
interview.
Gone into just talking. Yeah. Do I still like what? I still like
The touring, the performing, the small comedy clubs.
If I look, we obviously enjoy that. That's the dirty secret of show business: is we're having a good time,
uh-huh.
or we wouldn't be pretending to do a radio show in your basement right now. I mean, this is. The reason we're doing this is because we like it.
Yeah.
We like
uh-huh.
it, and and people like it, and so they're watching it, and so it's a win-win. We're all having a good time. But I'm going out to Laughs in Kirkland because it's a good time.
Yeah, it seems though that every comic is always trying to achieve. It seems like the ultimate goal is you know sort of a sitcom, a Seinfeld like sitcom based on your comedy.
It kind of used to be more that, I guess, than there's not so many sitcoms based on somebody's comedy nowadays as there used to be. Although now there is that Mike and Molly, which did you know that sitcom?
No,
it's Billy Gardell. It's fat guy with a fat
with
wife.
With a fat wife.
Oh, yeah,
right?
Yeah, okay, yeah.
They've
yeah.
kind of it's a riff on the theme of Fat Guy with a Hot Wife, which was so popular for a while, you know. That Kevin James show, you know, how many of them were there? But now it's like, well, why don't we make them both fat? Oh, this is a great idea.
Yeah.
And there's more fat people than there are hot people, so this is they're going to be able to mine this vein of gold for a long.
You're
time.
You're laughing, but he's being serious.
No, I'm just. I understand.
Yeah, that's true.
That's
mean,
how
people,
TV works. But they haven't been. They don't make sitcoms like they used to. They're not cranking them out because of the reality show thing. And then also a lot of times, you know, everybody, it's like I said earlier, when you go to the moon, then you wish you were on Earth. There's so many people who are on TV shows that then they're trying to go back out on the road to do stand-up because when you're out at a club like Laughs in Kirkland,
of course.
I'm just pretending as if people are listening to the pretend radio
no,
show.
No, it's just us.
Plug my gig, but I know. Well, our wives, well, let's face it, our spouses, our loved ones are
that's
listening.
Right.
No, mine has given up. She's upstairs. She's
upstairs.
Impressed that
I don't
I'm
know
down
what he's
here.
Doing. He comes up around noon. I make him a sandwich.
I've checked his equipment is not even plugged in. And by that, I mean this equipment here, not.
And the other stuff, too.
Yeah.
Anyway, I lost my train of thought. So you get on TV and then you wish you were back out on the road because you have so much control of your show. You write it and you make all your creative choices and you're doing it in the moment so you can change something without having a, you know, TV and movies are such a collaboration and everybody's got their own opinions and you got to talk about everything before you do it and then there's so many people involved that any one or two of them can start messing up the whole project.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like this what we're doing.
No.
Oh no. You want to make a change in direction right now?
We can do whatever.
Yeah.
Well, I want to know over there where those green lights are going up the bar thing.
Yeah, this is a sign that you're talking.
Is that up loud enough? Is that? Can you get it so it goes up into the red a little bit?
Put them in the red.
Will it go red?
Give Jake some reverb.
Oh, yeah, there. Look, it's getting yellow. That's nice.
You want some of this?
What is that like?
Oh, that's
a big... We're in the giant coffee can now.
Our stuff's phone and plugged in.
Yeah, okay. This is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We don't mess around.
I've also got this device over here that I'd like to bust out from time to time in case you want to do like a magic trick. I can go...
What is it?
How about that?
Wow, that's not... That's not just... Yeah, that is mad.
We're ready.
I stole this from a radio station.
Yeah. Oh, that one.
This one I... Yeah, well, what were you looking at? My God, you don't even know what we're doing.
I was looking at... It was like a magic trick because I was looking at what your other hand was doing and you were...
No, never look at what his other hand is doing.
No, this hand is always embarrassing.
Well, I can't tell which one is the other hand. That's the problem.
So, yeah, no, this is real radio equipment that radio stations don't use anymore because they don't have real live people anymore.
Did they have a garage sale when you left the radio station? They just said, you take whatever you want. We're not using this anymore.
We won't have people. What was funny is this company that we do part-time work with, we were in their building and we were starting the podcast and we said, you know, it'd be nice to have one of these devices. And I saw one sitting there and they said, oh yeah, we got a whole stack of them.
Yeah.
So in the corner, they literally had like six of them stacked up. And each one of these is, you know, $1,200 or something. So I said, well, I'll take this one. And oddly enough, it had all the sound effects on here from a radio show that she used to do 5 years ago.
Yeah.
That they just literally decommissioned it, put it on the stack and said, well, we won't use this one again.
Yeah.
So, why is it that they're getting rid of all the human beings in radio right now?
We cost them money.
Yeah, they cost them money.
Right, but when you just get down to music, like who's driving around in their car like, I hope he plays my song. It's like, don't you have all your CDs and your iPod and all your music? You can play all the music you want. What I want is a person to talk to me.
Radio.
That's why I drove all the way over here, Marty, just so someone would talk to me.
There's always Dave. You could talk to Dave.
Dave's great, but I've talked to him for a while.
Yeah.
I mean, right? It's been a whole day and a half.
Yeah. I know.
Well, that's
how we feel too, which
is
the problem.
They're playing to their weakness. By saying, hey, we're going to play the best music of the 70s, 80s, 90s, and today. I mean, I'm like going, okay, nobody is doing that anymore. Nobody.
Right, I already have all that music in my cabinet. Why do I need to turn on the radio to hear that?
Yeah.
I don't need that.
They bring people into the radio station, they give them pizza, and they say, do you like this song? Do you like this song? How much do you like this song? Do you like this? And then based on what, like, six weird people who will do anything for free pizza say, they will adjust an entire radio station and fire people.
This is the other thing. It's like, I'm listening to the radio to find out what is good that I should like.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, not like
I'm
what
trying
I did
to find
like
what
I was
are
17.
What are some new songs that I could start liking?
Oh, you would have loved the station
so
that fired us.
I have so many other songs already. I have all the songs of things that I already like.
Right?
I want you to tell me new things to like. You're the expert. You go out and tell me. There's too much of the, well, let's ask the audience what they want. They don't know what they want. They're in their houses. They're busy. They're going to work. Mm-hmm. They want someone to help them find new things to like.
Every time we did music research at the radio station, they would come out with a list of 500 songs and then rank them from, you know, the most popular. And it always turned out, and they would even kind of like laugh it off to a certain extent, the people doing the research, they'd say the top songs are always the most familiar ones.
Right.
And I'm going, yes. If you play a completely unfamiliar song to a person and you say, is this your favorite song of all time? They're going to go, well, no.
That somebody recognizes Rock the Casbah more than a song they've heard twice. And so then we play Rock the Casbah a million more times and a minority of people will say, God, can you guys stop playing Rock the Casbah? But no, we'll never stop playing Rock the Casbah. Not here. We don't play anything here because nothing's plugged in.
Yes,
there's no music. Yeah, well, we don't. Why play music when we've got us? We can talking.
Us, I mean, is much better than
you
music.
You put these headphones on, you can really hear yourself talking. I mean, I can hear you guys talking. Yeah, abracadabra. That was the music. It's gone.
We probably have to pay some license fee to a sound effect house.
Someday they're going to come. Yeah, they're going to come for
come
for
track
that.
Us down. So it seems like you really understand what radio should do and what it's not doing.
Right, but things are going to be different when I'm in charge, but I'm starting to think that might not happen. You know, you always, when you're in your 20s, you think, well, someday I'm going to be in charge, and then I'm going to really change everything. And now I'm kind of hitting that age like, wow, maybe I'm not going to get the keys to the car.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm not going to get to be in charge of stuff.
And you know, except, okay with that, I'm guessing.
I'm kind of okay, because now we can do our own, this is the new thing. Uh-huh. Everybody's going to be doing their own podcast, making their own
that nobody's
movies
listening
and videos.
To,
well,
but
somebody will.
Rather
well, the new trick
to
is going
to
be, how do you get people to listen? It used to be, well, people will listen to the radio because it's in their car and they turn it on and you're in there somewhere and they'll find you. because there's not that many things in there.
Right.
But now there's an infinite amount of things on the internet. So how do you get to be the thing that people are listening to? Yeah. I don't know what
don't
the trick
know,
is.
But you
nobody
have to
knows.
Tell us if somebody tells
eggs,
you.
Well, eggs Facebook. Jammed in the butt like she used to do on radio.
We once jammed hard-boiled eggs up people's asses for Incubus tickets. Those were the days.
Yeah, but that's not, we're not doing that.
No.
The days are gone. You got to jam the eggs in your own butt now. I mean, if you want people to listen to this podcast, Marty, drop some trowel and boil
Marty.
Some water because
here.
It's time.
Oh, how many times have I heard that? Drop some trowel and boil some water.
I happen to have this hard-boiled egg.
Yeah. That is usually the precursor to many exciting activities in this household.
I know it.
All right, Jake Johansson is here. He's playing at Laugh's Comedy Spot. Ordinarily, we'd be eager or feel pressure to get him on his way, but
I've got nowhere to go.
There is no other radio station in town.
Yeah, there's no... Well, no one has any talking on.
Yeah.
I mean,
right.
If I had recorded a classic rock song in the 80s...
Well, they still wouldn't want to talk to you, but they would play, maybe.
They would play it. Uh-huh. But that's where the real money is, isn't it? You know, let's just record one really good one of these, and then let them play it forever and pay us later for
that
it.
Is that
are those days over too?
No, those days are still here. I mean, we can't play somebody's song. We have to play like 40 seconds of it and then turn it off because we still feel like we're going to get caught. I mean, somebody's.
You think
money.
Someone's going to sue you if you play someone's song on the internet?
Definitely.
Yeah.
We were on the phone with John Hyatt talking about his new music, and we were like, "Can we play it?" And he was like, "Yeah, go ahead." But it turns out that
legally we can't play it because he doesn't even have the rights
right.
to his own music.
Even though we were on the phone with him and we asked him and he was like, yep, go ahead. We still couldn't do it.
Who said you couldn't?
The people who know the law regarding music licensing.
Well, right, but you don't... Come on.
I know.
We're
on the phone with him.
Do you think that's how Dick Cheney plays ball? That is not how you do it.
Good point.
You play the music and then they send you an email and then you tell them you're going to stop and then you keep doing it.
Yeah.
And then they send you a letter and then you tell them you're going to stop and then you keep doing it. And then they send you another really serious letter from their lawyer and then you tell him you're going to stop. In fact, you call him up and you say you're really sorry and then you keep doing it. And then when they finally show up out there, you go, oh, I'm sorry. Really? I can't believe that machine is still doing that. I'm going to turn it
Don't
off.
Don't you somewhere along the line also say, oh, and by the way, I've changed the law. Now I can do it. I've rewritten the law so that I am
well,
the,
eventually, once you finally have gotten them to run chase you around the tree so many times, you go, are you sure that's what the law says?
Yeah.
Let's talk to my lawyer. Oh, wait, I don't have one. Can you wait a minute while I get a lawyer? I got to get a lawyer so I can have him talk to your lawyer.
Awesome strategy.
Apologize later is always such a good one. If I had any balls, I would be like, yeah, let's play it. But I don't have any.
Well, what are they going to do? John Hyatt's record company is going to sue you because you played his song on your podcast? And what are you going to say? The only person listening is my damn wife, and she doesn't even listen anymore. She's up there boiling eggs so I can jam them in my ass to get people to listen to the show.
That's our whole next week.
Yeah. Right, I hear you. This next song is a great song for boiling water to...
Well, my God, there's a strategy.
I'm telling you, I'm not a lawyer, but I see how they operate.
They should give you the keys to the car.
So, things are gonna. Well, we're gonna see what it can do. I'll tell you that.
I'll just tell you what our air check sessions would have been wholly different.
Right.
You know, today's show is good, but Marty, really, let's loosen up the sphincter.
People will suddenly start listening more if you are in your living room jamming eggs up your ass with nobody watching and nobody knowing. Just trust me.
I would have loved that serious discussion with, okay, yeah, you know, it is kind of 2005 with you jamming eggs up listeners' asses. Yeah. It's time to...
It's time for the eggs to go in your ass.
There wasn't any air checking back then. We did whatever we wanted.
And you know what? This is the other thing. You don't go... You know how many eggs will fit in your ass, okay?
3.
But the listeners don't know that.
Right.
So you start off, you're going to see if you can get one in there, right? And then that's something you can talk about that for probably a year, that time that you put that egg in your ass. But meanwhile, you know you can get 3 in there. So next year, it's no problem for you to double up on your egg ass trick.
Bigger
you
and
know?
Better.
Right. Man, let's say we do it on Easter.
We've got to come up with a sexier name for it. The egg ass trick is just, not all that.
Okay, well, I'm going to work on it during the commercial. Oh, that's right. We don't have any. You got to get some commercials. Why don't you have any commercials?
No,
nobody wants to give us any money.
Well, see, if nobody's giving you any money, how can you get in trouble for playing music?
I just don't
get it.
Yeah,
I
that's
know.
A good point. And I've said this many times. I would love to be sued by somebody because then, you know, I mean, just think of the publicity. John Hyatt's record. Why has everything all of a sudden gotten quiet?
Because I was thinking, well, would there be
publicity?
Yeah,
when you said I would love to be sued by somebody, I just thought, I mean, that's like that's like saying I'd love to be struck by lightning by God or something. You just don't say that.
That's right.
I didn't just say it. I was saying it was like saying that. I didn't say it.
If you want to be sued by somebody.
Apparently Jake wants to be sued by somebody.
I don't. No, you want to be sued by somebody. Oh, I'm saying I don't want to be struck by lightning.
I'm going to fall going down your stairs and then I'll sue you. If you want.
I don't want that kind of a lawsuit. I want a lawsuit for something we've done on the program.
Yeah, it would be good publicity if you and I get into a big fight, though, and I sue you because your Prius ran me over and, like, broke my baby or something.
Yeah.
Broke your baby.
Yeah, I got a baby inside.
Right now?
I'm making a man.
Really?
Yep.
Is it a dude? Do you know it's a dude?
It's a man. Mm-hmm. I saw his stuff.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah.
You have a son or a daughter?
I have a daughter.
Daughter, so do I.
I have a daughter.
How old is your daughter?
She's six now.
Six?
She's
wow.
in... kindergarten. How old's your daughter?
Four.
Four?
Yeah.
She's in kindergarten. You know, this, so I have this because my daughter gave me this to remember. It's like a little rubber band thing. This is a, it's
that's
a
cute.
Moon. Silly bands. This is what they're doing now in kindergarten is they got these, this
bracelets.
One looks like a moon and, you know, there's some of them look like a princess. Yeah, except it's too tight to go on my wrist, so I double it around on my finger because, anyway.
That's
but that's
cute.
The new, that's the trend with kindergartners cute. And first graders is the silly bands. They're all wearing these rubber band things that are shaped like something before you put them on, and then they just look like you got a rubber band.
Here's a question I struggle with. When is your daughter's birthday?
July.
July. So is she? Yeah, okay. That's
she perfect. Could have gone to kindergarten when she was five, but we decided to wait.
Okay, that is exactly the struggle we have. My
whether you're going to have the old kid or the young kid
the youngest
in the class.
Or the oldest in
well,
the class. My daughter's birthday just... a couple days ago, September 29th. So do we hold her?
Hold back.
Hold
Trust
back.
Me. I've got friends who have a son and a daughter, and their son they sent early, and their daughter they waited a year, which if you were going to do, if you had to do, were you going to go one and the other?
It
you would hold the boy back, not
yes,
the girl.
Because we're slow.
But it's like you're redshirting them.
Uh-huh.
You know? That way they get a chance to mature a little bit more. And it's
so
not
is she just kicking ass over the other kindergartners?
Well, not necessarily, but she's more ready to go to kindergarten. You know, she's not freaked out and crying and worried about that stuff. She's anxious to learn how to read and she wants to be in school, and so she's motivated about that. And then that keeps paying off later when everybody is getting into boys. You know, she'll be a little bit older and more emotionally kind of
that is the conventional yeah. reason. But I have a July birthday and I was always young for my age, and I always felt like it pushed me along. Granted, I sucked in sports as a result.
Yeah.
I was,
right. Well, you should read that Malcolm Gladwell.
I did read
that. Okay.
Oh,
so
no.
My wife handed that to me and said, here, this will make the case for holding our daughter back.
Don't
yeah,
get
you
him
wanna
started.
Wait. You want to wait. You want to wait. That's I'm with your wife on this. Get her down here.
She's busy.
And have her bring some eggs.
All right. Jake Johansson's here. He's at Laughs Comedy Spot in Kirkland. Jody gives us a quick update. See, it's like a real radio show.
This sound makes it seem like now we're hooked up.
Now we're
going to
do the news.
Uh-huh. We're doing the news?
Uh-huh.
Really?
Yeah. But news like, you know, not all the news that's fit to print, but news
See,
that's interesting.
If you want to get sued, where'd you get the news? Where's that coming from?
I did research.
From your news team?
I called my news team.
This is the thing. Now they're going to sue you because you went on the internet and you looked at somebody's
please.
Website to find something out.
Please,
now they're going to
sue
you.
I hope they sue us.
And not only that, but you're speaking English. And guess what? Merriam-Webster owns that.
Tell that bitch to phone and come after me, because we have to talk about important things like Barack Obama making the official announcement. And I have to admit, I was wrong and you were right, Marty.
Did I say something right?
You
again?
Said something right. Rahm Emanuel, chief of staff, is resigning to go be the mayor of Chicago, or run for it and hopefully be elected. And why wouldn't he be elected?
Yeah.
Give me a break. And I had said, why wouldn't you want to be the chief of staff for friggin' Barack Obama? And you were like, nope. Mayor of Chicago is better because it's...
Because everything's going to hell in a handbasket. And
yeah.
He's like, all right, I'm out.
I'm surprised.
Well, I don't know if it's going to hell in a handbasket. But yeah, it's would you rather be in charge of some shit or in charge of somebody else's being in charge of
I would
shit?
Like to be the chief of staff for the president.
Really?
Yeah, chief of staff.
Well, I got news for you. There's an opening.
Do you think I'm ready?
Well, let's just... I don't think it's going to be hard to get out of your current job.
Yeah.
You can just walk away from this.
Bye, Marty.
As soon as you get a couple eggs up Marty's ass.
So, help me. I will sue
you're
you.
You're on your own.
And then I will publicize the lawsuit.
Well, yeah. I don't know. How do you get to be chief of staff? Because
yeah.
that could be as close as maybe I'm not going to get to be president, but maybe I could get to be chief of staff.
Well, yeah.
I would. My wife is from New Zealand. I would just like to be the ambassador to New Zealand.
That would be awesome.
I get along with
seriously,
them already.
An ambassadorship, best gig in the
best
world.
Best gig in the world.
You live in these highfalutin houses.
diplomatic license or diplomatic immunity. You could kill someone. I've watched a lot of TV. You could kill someone and get away with it.
Yeah, but you don't want to be the ambassador to Czechoslovakia or Albania.
Especially because that doesn't exist anymore.
Okay. Well, good, because no, I didn't really insult anyone.
Well, you insulted two
countries. What about Somalia? Would you like to be the ambassador to Somalia? Yeah, I don't think we probably even have an ambassador there now.
No.
Yeah.
It's lawless. Yeah. I don't think they have a government.
What'd you say? You can be a Japanese ambassador.
Ambassador to Japan?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be great.
Oh, my God. Just think of the cock and swaggers rolling through town.
Of course, Yaz thinks Japan would be the best one. Yeah. Of course. So here's something interesting, speaking of countries and things. It's been 92 years since World War I ended, but technically it hasn't ever ended. This is going to blow your mind. Remember the Treaty of Versailles that ended the war? We all learned about the Treaty of Versailles. Yeah. The Germans owed $35 billion to the winners of the war. That's us, the French, and the Brits. $35 billion would be $400 billion today, incidentally. But the war couldn't be officially over until the whole thing was paid off. And it'll be paid off this coming Sunday, October 3rd.
This coming Sunday, they're finally going to make the last
coming
installment.
Coming out with their satchel of money and...
Yeah,
we already cashed for clunkered that thing.
I know,
you know,
but isn't that amazing?
I mean, they finally are making the last payment on something we quit driving.
I mean, talk about an annoying payment, like a balloon payment, just like over your head.
Well, I'll tell you how much they didn't like it. World War II.
No joke.
Yeah,
seriously.
No joke. And that shit's probably not over either. Here's the best headline from MSNBC. U.S. infected Guatemalans with STDs more than 60 years ago. I didn't do any research into the story. I don't know what it's about, but that's the best headline of the day. We infected Guatemalans with STDs
well,
like 60 years ago.
Well,
and
Columbus
we're infecting everybody with STDs all the time. Wear a condom, people. Seriously. And put your egg in a condom before you shove it in your butt.
Of course. Of course. Now, remember
I'm
when...
I'm getting all kinds of helpful tips.
Remember when you thought that Bono was faking his back injury and that's why the event at Quest Field was canceled and all that stuff? To be rescheduled Saturday, June 4th next year. Well, now they're telling us who the opening acts are going to be. YouTube.
No, you're so late with this.
We didn't talk about it yesterday.
Lenny Kravitz. And
this is for the opening acts for Bono next June of 2011.
Right. The opening acts for YouTube.
Breaking news.
We didn't talk about it on the air yesterday.
Well, I mean, it seems like most people would be on this.
Really?
Yeah. Lenny Kravitz.
Jake,
right?
Do you know?
I don't know. I don't know anything. I can't keep up with
Dave,
YouTube.
Dave, do you know?
I'm
Yaz,
going to see.
Do you know? Oh.
Oh, okay. Does well, it, yeah. Maybe I'm just ahead of Yaz.
Yeah. Lenny Kravitz is going to be here. Also, Snow Patrol, who we were talking about yesterday. The Fray.
Never heard of him.
Yeah, Snow Patrol?
Snow Patrol?
Really?
Never heard of him.
Yeah, I don't
know. No, you know why? They
him.
Don't play him on the radio because they're busy playing
sadly,
the best
they
soft
play
rock
Snow
of the 70s.
A lot.
Oh, they did? Yeah. Okay, sorry.
And Florence and the Machine, my new favorites. They're going to be
Florence,
everyone, too.
Florence the Machine?
Florence and the Machine.
Florence and the
Redheaded
Machine.
Now, that's
Brit.
True. That's one that they don't really play on the radio that they should because hot.
Florence. Is there a Florence?
There is. Yeah, okay. Her name is Florence.
Keep going.
One final thing. Kurt Cobain once wrote a nasty letter to MTV when he was alive.
How many years has he been dead now?
Yes, but this is Seattle. And anything that's uncovered about him. I mean, we're doing a retrospective at Seattle Art Museum that's going to like blow people's minds. I mean, people are still obsessed with Nirvana here, especially. Mm-hmm. He once wrote a nasty letter to MTV, never sent it, but somehow somebody dug it up and it's now being auctioned off. As of late last night, the current bid was $2,500. We haven't checked this morning. Here's what it reads.
Letters that he wrote but didn't send?
Never sent, yeah.
Doesn't count then.
Well, it's like a diary entry.
Dear MTV.
Dear Empty TV.
Okay.
Yeah. The entity of all corporate gods. We will survive without you easily. The old school is going down fast. My life's dedication is now to do nothing but slag something. Kurt Cobainy, professional rock musician. And he spelled his name all sorts of crazy.
Oh. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
My life's goal.
Yeah. I say that thing's going to go for 10 grand. By the
really?
Time it's done.
I'm not buying that.
Yeah. No?
We're going to see my wife and I when I get home after my big weekend at Laughs in Kirkland, Washington. I'm going to fly home on Sunday and we're going to go to the, I guess it's the LA State Fair or the California State Fair, and we're going to see OK Go.
Yeah.
And they're opening up for some band that my wife has never heard of.
Really?
That I didn't even listen to because I just assumed, well, I've never heard of them either.
Do you know their name?
Well, no, you'd have to. You could Google the State Fair, OK Go, and then I think you could figure that out.
Are you
out.
Going this for
not
your own sake,
you.
Or are you going to expose the kid to the.
No, she's not going.
Party.
She's not going.
You're
this
not
is
bringing
a grown
the kid
up.
To this fair?
We're not going to the fair. The show is at the fair. And we're going to be at the fair because
I know you'll
that's
be at
you
the fair, and
to.
Kids seem to have a good time at the fair. I think you should bring your daughter to the fair.
Right. It's too late. School night. She's got to go to school the next day.
That's very sad. Because
she's in kindergarten. You think it's easy to go to kindergarten? You got to get there 15 minutes early if you want any monkey bar time before school starts. And let me tell you something. They all do.
Speaking of monkey bars, this story you didn't cover today in your little news update, that tomorrow in Kent, Washington, which is a town that's about 20 miles south of Seattle, they are unveiling their first video playground equipment.
Yeah.
At Wilson Field in Kent.
I
what
saw
does that,
that
mean?
Yeah.
What does video playground
it's
mean?
It's an electronic interactive gadget that's on the playground. That because they feel like playgrounds can't compete with the video games any longer. So now playground equipment manufacturers are saying we will start incorporating computer electronics and
well, this is a great area to test that out because it's so dry.
Yes, seriously.
I can't believe the one thing you don't want around computers is moisture. And so they're going to do an outdoor computer.
They've probably sealed that up. It's a playground game station that encourages kids to chase blinking lights and challenge other kids to competitions. If you want to play in an aggressive, hotly competitive way, there are games that provide that platform. Or if you want to work on memory skills or do a game that's more cerebral, the playground gadget will allow that.
The kid who's working on memory skills is going
to
get his ass kicked.
Memory skills. Yeah. People want to climb on stuff. Yeah. I want to do some crazy, dangerous thing.
Yeah.
You know, they love to do this thing at they have one of those spiral slides, and what they do at the playground is they go to the top and then they flop out over the slide and hold on and go down the side of the slide. That's with their hand over hand. Yeah, they're trying.
That's
to
what your
out.
Daughter does because she was held back and she's more advanced than all the other kids.
No, the other kids teach her how to do that.
Oh,
yeah,
those other kids. Oh, the other kids. So if you're interested, Wilson Playfield in Kent tomorrow afternoon, 1 o'clock. That's literally a ribbon cutting ceremony this piece of playground equipment, the first of its kind here in the state of Washington. Did you find out about the L.A. State Fair?
I did. Who it took it? Me some
who's
time.
Who's the other act?
The act is 303.
Yeah.
They're like a pop group.
Yeah.
You don't want to stay for it. Just
leave. You don't want to stay for it.
You don't want to stay for it, and your wife probably doesn't either. Yeah.
I can't believe that OK Go is opening for them. That's what we can't believe.
Yeah.
That's who we want to go see. But that's eventually we're going to be watching you two open up for somebody.
Yeah. Right? It's true.
That's the way
probably
true.
Not.
You're
probably
making
not.
The right decision.
Jake Johansson, he's playing at Laughs Comedy in Kirkland. Always a pleasure to have you with us. Thanks for going with the flow.
It's been good. This is fun. I don't know why you didn't switch over to podcasting sooner.
We should.
I mean, it's more fun.
We
it's
say
more
this
fun.
All the time.
Yeah.
We come out of this show every day and we're just
now,
electrified.
Is this a real podcast? Like I could subscribe and listen to it, or I could download it to my pod
yeah,
in
absolutely.
LA and listen
yes.
to it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. You should. You should listen to yourself and see what you sound like.
Yeah, there's two components.
I love doing that. Yeah.
There's the live feed that we're doing right now with the chat room where everyone's saying that they want to go to Laughs this weekend. And then you can get it on iTunes or at MartyReamer.com.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, well, on iTunes, do you get the video one or just get the talkie one?
You just get the talkie.
If you want to watch the video, you have to go to MartyReamer.com.
Yeah, that's right.
That's right.
Okay. And then is that just streaming, or can you click on it and watch it anytime?
You can click on it and watch it anytime.
Okay, thanks. I'm helping you, but I'm also learning things for my own.
You need your own podcast. All the good comics are doing them
all
now.
All I need is three cameras and that thing with the knobs on it and some microphones and a Japanese dude.
Yeah.
Right?
That's essential.
Yeah.
He's
yeah.
kind of essential to the whole formula.
He's the guy who goes, while you're doing the podcast, he goes out in the driveway to make sure you're coming to the right house.
That's right.
Well, what was weird about that is we were right in the middle of like a heated discussion about the future of radio. And then all of a sudden, a weed whacker went off outside. And Yaz was just like, doop! And he just bolted out. And I went, does he think that Jake's going to come with, you know, a back... powered leaf blower, you know, just
no, they charge you $25 a bag now, so I can't bring my leaf blower on the road anymore.
Charge you $25 bucks.
The airlines,
a bag.
You can't check. If you're going to try and check a leaf blower, that's going to cost you $25 bucks.
He just went to Hawaii with five people and made everybody take one little tiny bag.
It's so backwards. So, I mean, not to embark on a whole different discussion here, but it's backwards. They should charge the people who carry their bags on.
Onto the plane.
Yeah. Because then chop, that flight would be on time because they handle the bags. You'd never get them, but whatever.
It's so ridiculous. It's so ridiculous that they, and then they try and tell you like, well, some people don't bring a bag, so we're only charging the people who want to bring a bag. You can't go anywhere without a bag. Yeah, I got to take a bag.
Yeah.
You know, just your ticket includes if I got to pay for my bag, then what about the person next to me who's got 100 pounds on me, like this giant Samoan dude that I'm sitting next to now?
Yeah.
That guy should have to pay $50.
That's
bucks,
a genetic condition,
and B,
Jake. Go easy.
He's also, he's in my seat. Yeah. He's in my seat. This guy is in my seat.
Well, remember, Southwest Airlines tried to do that, and people did not appreciate it. Remember, if you blooped over into another seat, they would charge you for two, and people went nuts.
Well, right. So make the seats bigger.
Right.
I'm going nuts because I got somebody's bloop in my seat.
I know. It's not fair. Know?
And you're probably flying first class, so if they're blooping...
No, I'm not. Sometimes I am, but not always.
Dave, you didn't fly him in first class?
Are you kidding me?
Did you
We're
fly
trying
coach
to turn
here?
A profit on this thing.
Yeah.
Right? We're trying to turn a profit on this thing.
Dave's like, I told him not to bring a fucking bag.
Yeah.
Did you check
you
a bag?
Come up here commando, my friend.
Did you check a bag?
Yeah, I checked a bag because I got t-shirts and CDs that I sell after the show. I'm running a small gift shop after the show. See, you think you're trying to pick up your money on the internet, and I'm running a little gift shop. It's like a museum. You go to right. the museum, and then on the way out, I try and sell you a calendar.
Gosh, you have to schlep your own merchandise. So if you don't sell at least $25 worth of merchandise, it's a net loss.
Right, 50 because I got to pay for
oh,
the
you
bag
pay
to go
for
back.
It to go back.
Mm-hmm.
That's
yeah,
annoying.
That's right. At that point, I just dump that merch and say this.
Forget it. I'm out of the business. You know what? I'm going to phone the show in next time. I'm going to pod the show. I'm going to pod my show.
That's right.
I wonder if it would cost less to send it in advance, like a big box UPS.
I looked into that. It doesn't. But someone is eventually going to... That's what I don't get. It's like for $25, the airline should come... They should come to my house and pick it up and take it to the hotel.
Yeah.
That's what that should... Yeah.
If you had a Japanese guy now, he would drive it up 2 days in advance.
I can't afford a Japanese guy.
No. Korean, maybe, but not Japanese. We broke the bank.
Yeah.
That's what we tell him. He said, the bank's broken. Sorry. Sorry. No,
maybe tomorrow.
No pay for you. He doesn't understand how it works over here.
I'm confused, too.
But if the bank is broken, you could still probably get paid. Or you should. Nobody does.
No.
This kind of was bonus content. We should charge for the bonus content
right.
because it sounded like I was wrapping the
you
show
You were
up.
Wrapping it up.
But it wasn't. Yeah,
and
it's
then,
not over.
And then it caught kind of...
When you say there's no rules, there's no rules.
No.
That means it could be an hour. How long is the podcast usually? Let me ask you that.
Well, here's what's interesting. We started out a half an hour, and then I had radio in my brain, which was always, you know, you got to stick to a very tight structure. Got to get to a traffic report. Got to play 8 minutes worth of commercials every 5 minutes. And then Jody was like, hey, loosen up, jackass.
Because if it was half an hour and we were still going strong or somebody was interesting or whatever, you know, he'd start to twitch and like, you know,
right.
have to shut it down, even though it was great. So we started creeping into 5 minutes after 10, quarter. Now sometimes we hit an hour and he doesn't even care. Look at him. He's relaxed.
Look at him. Totally relaxed. Although we should have shut this show down about 45 minutes.
So this is the whole, have I been the whole podcast? Is this the whole podcast?
Well, we started 10 minutes before you got here.
Yeah,
we start at 9:30 every day.
We were rolling.
Yeah. I see. Yeah. Because people are, it's a destination. You can't just totally half-ass it. You got to, some things have to happen. And
yeah.
We're supposed
same
to
time
happen.
Every day.
And then when you introduced yourself with the leaf blower going, here I am.
What you need to do though is now get an iPhone app so people can suck this right onto
we're
their
working
phone
on it.
Yeah, we are. We have a whole crew.
We have a guy working on it.
A guy.
Japanese.
We have a guy. Also?
No, he's white.
Not Japanese.
He's a white guy.
I don't yeah.
We should have gotten an Indian.
Yeah, we really should have.
I mean, let's just play to every nationality's strength.
Yeah. We should have.
An international kind of person, you do this.
Yeah,
you're the person.
Just some guy out on the street.
I have not done that one. Of
you're
these.
Gonna make us an iPhone app, and that's the end of it. That's good. That's how it could have gone.
It seems like we should be exploiting Yaz's strengths more.
We do.
A lot of times he's just standing there.
Yeah, he is.
And he could. It seems like he could be. You could have him doing other stuff. Like I thought he was gonna come down here with a few hot eggs a while ago.
He's switching the video camera.
In his head, he was like, Yaz is probably going, I could probably boil in 5 minutes. But those would be soft boiled eggs and that'd be a mess.
That would be a mess. That's not how you do it.
Yeah. Well,
I'm the only
anybody,
one who's done this before
anybody,
and I know.
What?
I
Oh, you did it. You've seen it. But
did
you
it.
didn't put
it in the gentleman's rear. Someone had to take pictures. I know.
Yeah, yeah.
I used
now
to get paid to. I used
you
to get
see
you
in
paid.
A whole different light now, don't you?
I know.
That's how many hand washings ago?
None.
A lot?
None.
Zero.
It was like 6 years, so no washes at all. Yeah, I used to be a shock jock.
Yeah, that's.
Yeah, we used to torture
well,
people.
Well, I just got shocked.
I know.
I just got shocked.
It was fun.
Did they ever bring you on shows like that? Where because
usually they try and separate the, you know, this is a person who's in real show business from this is a person who's here to watch someone put an egg in their butt.
Uh-huh.
they try and draw the, even though you and I know there isn't really a line
there's
between
not really
that
much
you
of
know.
A distinction there, but I understand that, but I would think radio would just like suck everyone into it at that point in time. Like when, if that was going on, that on the day that Jake Johansson was scheduled, you would have said, you know, here, Jake, you want the honor?
You know, it was really more of an insulated.
Well, sometimes they try and get, they don't do it because people would leave. Mm-hmm. I mean, I might leave. I might, it's just like, look, I don't want to see some other, there's plenty of buttholes that I would love to take a look at, but not.
Yeah, plus,
not
I mean,
the guy who's showing up at the radio station to, you know.
When you could do anything, you didn't really need guests. Like, we really didn't have guests. Listeners were guests, and then we just stunted.
Yeah.
Like, if you could do anything, then you don't want guests. Like, let's do another thing. It's not like we did the egg thing all the time. It was just one day for Incubus tickets. I was
It was probably a week build-up to it, too, talking about it and who's coming in and who's signed up and what their name is and what their wife thinks about it and all this other stuff. And
it was all young dudes. Young guys in their early 20s will literally do anything for free stuff. And so talk about exploiting.
Yeah.
And
then the following week, he had people...
That's why you hold them back a year before you let them start school.
That's right. You want them in your mid-20s before you let them loose on the world. Maybe then I'll hold her back 5 years.
5 years.
And why not?
Eventually, you get in a little trouble with the law. You know, you talk about somebody showing
sue
up
me.
To sue you. Play a song. Will you play a friggin' song for crying out loud?
No, instead he's going to keep his daughter locked in her room for 10 years. That's like a better option.
You want a song? You want a song? Something that'll get us sued?
Huh? Yeah. How about Happy Birthday?
Oh, no. I know what one he's going to play.
That's right. What do you think?
Play that one that we like.
This one here?
Gotcha!
Yeah.
This guy's so dead. You thought I didn't see you now, didn't you? No one's going to...
You try to sneak by me now, didn't you? He just got nominated for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Now give me what
you
promised me.
Yeah.
You know this song?
Yeah, but I don't know. Who is it?
Joe Tex.
It is Joe Tex. Yeah, Joe Tex is awesome.
That's the way you react when you don't know and somebody tells you, you go, oh, yeah, it is that guy.
Well, no, I know Joe. I have a Joe Tex CD.
You do?
I wonder if I have it on my...
In your pocket?
Oh,
I might have it on my... I might have it here on my pod. Yeah.
So we have to go over 40 seconds.
Yeah.
And it has to be a little less than incidental.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden Joe Tex's clan is going to come after us.
The Tex clan?
Well, it'd be his record company, wouldn't it?
Well, I mean, he's got publishing. He's got a record label. You've got so many people you got to pay off to be able to play a song on a podcast.
I don't know if we're going to get sued on this one because he's not alive. And so he's less interested whether he's making money or not.
Yeah, tell that to Jimi Hendrix's family. You'd have eight families coming after you if you played Jimi Hendrix's music.
That's
true. I don't think I have Joe Tex.
Oh, that's so very sad. Well, then I'm glad we played something you didn't have.
Nice.
This should be your new favorite.
Jimi Hendrix will sue you?
Jimi Hendrix
has family.
You're right in his wheel.
Yeah, there are
area.
Six different bastions of his family, and they all hate each other, and, you know, they all feel like they should get a little... slice of the pie.
Yeah.
I can't believe there's any pie left at this point.
Oh, there's pie. There's like houses full of stuff that isn't released and, you know, they're going to release it. They're going to let it out a little bit and then everyone's like, where's it coming from? The foundation or the sister's foundation or whatever?
But they better turn some of that loose pretty soon or it's like pretty soon. There's
people
not people
forget?
Who don't know who... Yeah, I mean,
trust me.
Eventually... Don't
now that there's no, like, voices on radio anymore, they got plenty more time to play All Along the Watchtower. And Purple Haze, Foxy Lady. Jake Johansson, he's playing at Laughs Comedy Spot. I highly encourage you to go out and see him perform and buy his merchandise. Don't make him pay to haul it back.
Please.
Yeah.
That's sad. Please.
Sell out his merch.
Please. Pick up a t-shirt.
My
pick
God.
Up a CD.
That's just so sad to see him at check-in going, yep, the bag is going back.
I couldn't move the shirts.
Really a pleasure to have you here, Jake. Thanks
Thank
very
you.
Much. All right. Jake Johansson, Laughs Comedy Spot in Kirkland. That's it for the week. I'm doing fake radio.
Yeah.
We'll see you again 9:30 Monday morning. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.
Wholly independent since 2009, this has been the Marty Reimer Show Podcast. For more information about topics discussed, visit our website, MartyReimer.com. That's Marty, MartyReimer.com. Thank you for subscribing to the podcast. Tell your friends. They look nice. Oh, and to subscribe to our podcast, that too. The Marty Reimer Show is a production of Twisted Scholar Incorporated. Remember, in America, a corporation is a person too.
I'm your Devil May Care announcer, Blair Schultz. See you next time. Word out.
Goodbye, Marty. Goodbye, Jody.